All right, so good afternoon, fellow UX Society members, and welcome to UX Design's first workshop entitled The Only UX and Figma Crash Course You'll Ever Need. So my name is Krisha Pardillo from 4BSMIS, and I'm very excited to be your host for today's workshop. So without further ado, let us meet our first speaker. So our first speaker for today is our very own VP for UX Design, Rafael Ditoff. So he is a junior studying BFA Information Design and is currently a product design intern at Swarm. So let us all give it up for Rafa. Rafa, please take it away.
Hello, guys. Can you hear me? Yes, you can. Okay, can you see my screen? Yes, you can. Okay, guys. Hello. Kamusta naman mga Swifties dyan? All Too Well, 10 minutes version, Taylor's version, on repeat. Kaya pa ba natin? Okay, also to my hello fellow ones, like love is not a science daw, sabi ni Nayon. Stream red and scientist, guys. Let's go. So hello, once again, I'm Rafa from 3BFAID. So I've been keeping myself busy as the VP for UX and UX Society, and I'm also a product design intern at Swarm. So I joined UX Society technically when I was still high school pa lang through UX University, but officially became a member nung freshman na syempre. So this will be my first talk ever. So I guess this is my time to give back to the community. So here, I'll be talking about user experience. So this is going to be a crash course trying to fit everything in less than an hour. So it's not going to be too shallow, but not too deep as well. So before we start, guys, I just want to ask you guys, like I want to test the waters. What do you guys think user experience means? Can you chat them in the Zoom chat below? I want to see your reactions and your thoughts. For you guys, what is UX? Okay, mahiya guys, I don't bite. Okay. Sige, later. Baka medyo hindi pa UNX. Get over it. So when I ask this question, usually people say, oh, UX is creating wireframes. Oh, it's a bunch of user interviews. Some say it's what you do in Figma. The others say, oh, it's just checking out UI, judging how the screens look, mga ganun. So technically, these are right answers, but they are wrong at the same time. So it's right because you guys mentioned like these processes like wireframes, interviews, practices, they are a part of UX, but what's wrong is that you can't just take one part of the process and call it UX agad. So for example, sinabi ko, I was able to interview a BSMIS senior kahapon. So call me a UX king, like agad-agad, like I mean sure, but hindi talaga, nope. So what is UX? What is user experience? User experience involves all the aspects of a person's interaction with a company, like yung mga products niya and the services. So based on the definition, nakasulat dyan, all aspects. So this means that user experience starts even before using the product or the service. So it starts from the very beginning. How does the user learn about your product? So for example, gumagamit ako ng Instagram. And I learned about their Reels feature. So they planned out that experience of discovery. So UX is a part of that. Next one, UX is also involved in the happenings. So this is the time when the user is already using the app. So let's say 2 days ago, nag-shopee ka dahil 11/11 sale. Is it easy to use the app? Like, is it hard? Is it confusing? So UX is a part of that. Next one naman is the endings. So UX is also involved when the user reaches the end of the journey. So let's say I was able to post an Instagram story. Tapos, how would you know if you get reactions or DMs? It's through notifications, right? So that's UX. If I don't like to be pinged naman, like for say you're using iPhone. So Apple has this do not disturb feature. So that's also a product of UX. So probably from a user interview, nag-share siya ng story niya na, oh, silent mode doesn't help me keep my focus. So that's why I need something else to block these notifications, something like that. So it came from stories and experiences. So if UX can be found anywhere, when is UX not there? UX is not just limited on like the things you do with your phones, like for example, like yung mga MacBooks and everything. You can see it also in the world around you, like your physical environment. So I have examples. The first one would be a banana. May UX pala sa banana? Like, yeah, meron. When you use the tip of the banana, tapos you peel it, you're touching the peel and not the banana itself. So the food is not gonna get dirty. Then eating it is very easy. Tapos pag natapos na yung banana, you dispose of it. You're still holding the peel, so there's no mess at all. Like the experience of eating that food is good UX. Another one is ketchup bottles. So in the Twitter verse, like this is very, hindi naman very, medyo controversial kasi sobrang dami nagsasabi, oh, the UI is like the glass ketchup bottles. Tapos UX is like the Heinz ketchup bottle. It's upside down, so mabilis na lang lumabas yung ketchup. So sabi nila, using Heinz is way easier than slamming that bottle and then still nothing comes out. Like, nasistress ka na lang talaga. So that's why yung upside down ketchup bottles, they're good UX now. And this example naman is ketchup packets. Like, bakit ketchup? Not ketchup. So hear me out, guys. So in ketchup packets, let's set a goal. So your goal here is to get ketchup on your plate or on your favorite food. So to give you a great experience, yung mga nag-manufacture ng mga ketchup packets, they made a crease on that packet. So you can just easily tear that apart and put the ketchup on the food. So that experience is very easy, right? But imagine if we're living in a non-ideal world. Chaotic siya. The packet doesn't have any crease. And as a user, or as a customer, wala ka rin scissors. So you will try to bite it, you will try to open it, tapos after some time, di pa rin siya gumagana. Like, you just give up, you don't eat, and then eventually you die. It's because of bad UX that you die. Okay, pero ganun talaga life. So how might we prevent like this unfortunate event from happening? So the question we might ask is, how might we make this experience the best that it can be, so that we know that this experience is the user experience, so we make it best or we make it better by UX design. Okay, so what is UX design naman? UX design is the process of improving the end user's experience of a product or service. So going back to my example kanina, you're using your phone during the 11/11 sale 2 days ago. So UX design's purpose is to make your online shopping experience easier and effective. So the question we might ask here is, how might we improve that experience or UX design? So we can do so by increasing user satisfaction. So, or as I would like to call it, putting a smile on the user's face. So that's the goal. So how might we put a smile on the user face or increase user satisfaction? By ensuring 3 points. And the first one is usefulness. So we can make sure that the product we're creating is useful by getting insights and getting feedbacks from users through yung mga interviews and testings. And in these UX activities, we learn about the user's pain points and also their frustrations. So we will work with the insights that we have. And a question to ask on usefulness is, are we solving the right problems? Are we creating a solution to a problem na meron na talaga sa world or gawa-gawa lang natin? So another way to make the people happy is through accessibility. Accessibility naman can be achieved by telling ourselves or reminding ourselves, why are we doing this in the first place? So it's because we want all users to have an easier experience or like the better way to reach their goals, right? So there are many ways to practice accessibility in design. So for the designs we see on our screen, or what you call user interfaces, you make sure that the colors use proper contrasts, or like the type or the font size you choose is not too small or not too big for the screen, because there are users na medyo mahirap makita or like malabo yung mata. So we take account for those people. So that's why accessibility is plus one. Next one would be pleasure. Pleasure is more of a visual design thing. So later I will be sharing with you guys why visuals and aesthetics are also important in UX. So with all of this, we have usefulness, accessibility, and pleasure. So how do we ensure this? We do so by doing the UX activities, the methods, and practices. So going back, we know that UX design is the process of improving the end user's experience or your experience using an app or a website. So now I'm going to show you what that process looks like. So we're going to go into a deep dive of the life of a UX designer. Okay. So step one is to empathize. So basically what I mean by empathy is being able to understand the needs of the users. So what do UX designers do to empathize? Here, user interviews. So user interviews might sound intimidating at first, but instead of interviews, think of these as coffee chats lang siya. Like, these are just conversations we have with our users just to get to know them more, their stories, their experiences. So why are user interviews important? These will give us the insights that we need on their pain points. So this will be the things that we're going to avoid or either solve, and also their motivations. So the things that we take advantage of. So the things that we get from this conversation can change your product direction. So since coming to the project, you have assumptions on what the solution might be. So these insights can either validate your assumptions or challenge them as you talk with your users. So for example, you are building an app for freelancers. So your question can be, can you give me an idea of what it's like to be a freelancer? So what's your usual day like? So they will answer, they will tell their stories. Tapos next question can be, how do you get projects? So basically, you're parang investigating on their life in a conversation-friendly way. So their experiences, yun yung data mo. So parang kwento lang talaga siya. Next would be empathy maps. So this is basically visualizing what we know about the user. So coming from the interview, you took down notes, yung mga experiences niya. So what we usually do is to place those insights into sticky notes. So during the interview, what are they thinking? What are they feeling? What do they see? What do they hear? What are their pain and gains? What do they say and do? So yung mga insights na to, we usually plot them into an empathy map that looks like this. So basically, this is the tool that we use to plot insights. And this will help you visualize what kind of user are you designing for. Like for example, si Jamie sa example na to, like yung feel niya is overwhelmed, anxious. So you have an idea that you're designing for a user that is probably like that. So that would also dictate your product direction as well. And the next thing that I usually do when I empathize or understand my users would be to do journey maps. So journey maps naman, these are the paths users take to achieve a goal while they're using the product or the services. So kasama dito sa journey maps yung of what they're thinking, what they're feeling, what they're doing. So through journey maps, you're going to have a clearer picture of what the users are going through to achieve like their goal. So this is an example. Your goal is to enlist for a class or like in a class. So since UX includes the beginning, so the first step is preparation. So let's say step one there is preparation. So on the first row, it's what are they doing? So probably in that first step for preparation, they're looking at the curriculum, they're checking out profs to pick, and then what they're feeling at that step is they're feeling anxious, they're feeling stressed, they're feeling worried. And then sa baba naman, what are they thinking? Bakit ako batch 2? Like, ano bang ginawa ko to deserve this? Like, relate naman guys, diba? Bakit walang slots? Paano ba ulit mag-enlist? Nakalimutan ko na. So that's step one. So we want to make the experience better, right? So in the first step, the user's feelings are negative agad. So there are definitely lots of problems that we can solve during this first step. It can be the batching system, the UI of the website. So there you go. Because of this journey map, you were able to brainstorm like what possible ideas are you going to do for that project. And then another thing that I do for empathizing is affinity mapping. So I like to call this sticky note sessions. So basically in an affinity map, you just gather as many insights as you can from your interviews. And then later on, you will organize them into groups. So you can use FigJam, you can use Miro. And if you haven't really explored FigJam or like Miro or Whimsical, you can use Jamboard naman Google. But I definitely recommend you guys to try out like FigJam. It's very nice. So what is affinity map? Like, can you give me an example? Ito. So example, each color represents the insights you get from a user during the interview. So let's say one person, orange lahat yung mga insights niya. Then the other is dark purple and so on. So you have all the insights right there. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna go through each one of the sticky notes and then group them by themes. So when you group them, this happens. So you will see there are a lot of sticky notes under the onboarding theme and the checkout. So this gives us an idea that most users are having issues or have a lot of insights in this part of the process. And probably as UX designers, we would prioritize working on these issues since a lot of users are experiencing that problem. So although may problems sa privacy and visual design, like that can be focused later on. And you can see naman like the urgency based on like what your users are telling you. So that's why we do user interviews. Okay, so we are done with step one. So the next step naman on the UX process or like the life of a UX designer is define. So what do we define? We define the goals, we define the measures, and we define the objectives. So like, feel free to like chat lang sa chat, like what you're thinking, your feelings, reactions, para fun. Okay, so the first step in defining is how might we? So in how might we's, we are turning problems and challenges into opportunities. So basically, we are reframing the pain points coming from the users into questions. And once it's been rephrased, like these questions can now initiate brainstorming sessions. So here's how you do it. So how might we then insert the problem here? So for example, yung problem mo is hindi ka nino-notice ng crush mo. So you're right. How might we get my crush to notice me? So mapapaisip ka, paano nga ba? Like, drop sa Zoom chat right now. Like, paano ba mananotice ng crush mo? Like, may tips ba kayo dyan? But for a legit example, let's say, pumunta ng Korea. But for a legit example, yun, you're doing a weekly newsletter. So your problem is, konti lang yung nagkiklik ng newsletter mo. So it would look like, how might we boost the open rate of my weekly digest? So mapapaisip ka na lang, so I can do that by changing the subject, like adding emojis to make it different from the rest of the emails, adding their names mismo so that they could call their attention, and also make the subject line clickbaity. So because of these questions, parang it allowed you to think of more solutions. So that's why you need to remember, how might we? the next step naman in defining is what we call user stories. So in user stories, this are it can be also called job stories. So basically, it's just a one-sentence explanation of a feature that is written from the user's point of view. So here's an example. As a user type, I want to do an action so I can get to an outcome. So for example, isa kang organized Bibo kid. So as a organized Bibo kid, I want to see my ongoing tasks listed in a table and also yung completed task ko gone. So I can focus on the things that I only need to do. And with that job story, tadan, nagawa yun ng Notion. Like Notion's filter feature on their databases. So like, you can feature na parang, oh, on this table, wala na yung mga completed tasks. So like that. So user stories will just serve as your guide whenever you're doing projects. So basically, it reminds you of your goals and what kinds of stories you want to achieve with the product you're trying to build. So ganun lang ka easy yung define. So basically, you define what you've empathized before in step one. So now, step two is done. We're done defining our goals and our objectives. And the next step is for us to ideate. So this is the time where we explore, we collaborate with our team members, and we get messy. So what UX activities are involved in this step? First will be user flows. So user flows, this will show you the paths that a user can take in a website or an app when they are completing tasks. So basically, user flows give you a bird's eye view on what steps the user will take in doing something. So for me, this part is really like the designing the experience stage, because you'll be determining ano yung mga actions that they will take to reach the next step. And then on that next step, what are the next options that they have? Paano po ba yung user flow nung sa crush? I mean, baka ikaw alam mo. Next. Ayun. So basically, in the user flow, you're making sure there's no ends. Like, there's no dead ends. So all the goals have a dedicated path towards it. So probably the start of your flow could be the sign up. Then after the sign up, creating an account. And then, syempre, pag naka-create ka na account, nasa homepage ka na, you'll have a nav bar. So that's 5 options that will go to different paths. So you're making sure like everything is attended to. The next one naman are wireframes. So wireframes are structural frameworks of your design. So these can either be sketched by hand or made digitally. So you'll be using shapes usually to represent the elements in a screen. So here, it's basically your first look on how the app or the website would look like without using too much resources. So here's an example of a wireframe. It just uses like shapes to illustrate what a page would look like. So for this example, the big blue square on the left side represents a calendar. The purple bar on the top represents the header. So parang when you're discussing your parang ideas or your explorations to your team, you didn't use a lot of time to explain what you're trying to build or like what do you plan to do for this specific page or for this specific design. Yeah. So that's the ideation part. Step 4 is the prototype. So this part is where we design, we iterate, and we mix. We basically bring it all together. So your user interfaces usually is the main activity here in the stage. So user interfaces are the visual design of the app or the website you're trying to build. So this can either be high fidelity and low fidelity. So that's another term. It's a new term. So what is fidelity? So basically, fidelity is the believability of the product or the service. So when I'm talking about low fidelity, basically, hindi sila believable. Since the higher the fidelity, the more believable it is. So low fidelities, ito yung mga wireframes or like initial explorations mo. Well, the next one, high fidelity, this will be the final designs. So this will contain like the branding, the proper layout, and the actual elements na mismo. And it's already something that can be used by the end users. So here is an example of a high fidelity user interface. This one, I created this earlier this year. So I designed an app that serves as a marketplace for online food businesses. So kaya siya high fidelity mockup because this is what you would see na usually on your phones or like what the users would use. And low fidelity interfaces naman would be like the wireframes that I've shown earlier. So yung medyo mga shapes pa lang siya, like basically wala pa siya mga branding and stuff. Another step in the prototype stage is copywriting. So these are the words that you see in the user interface, like the content mismo. So when it comes to design, content is everything. So basically, this will dictate what actions the user will take next. So for example, you're on a landing page and you see two buttons, sign in and sign up. So for a new user, sign in and sign up, they're very similar. So the new user will have to think about, what do I have to press again to create a new account? So if the user clicked the wrong button, magkakaroon pa ng frustration. So that's going to be a problem. But if it was labeled as sign up and log in, like mi difference, it would have been easier, right? So copy can also be a problem. So it's not just your design or how you lay out your website or your applications. So it's important to be able to connect with your users through words as well. And the last step of the life of a UX designer is, how do we know when we're doing the right things? Like we already did the design, we already did the copy. The next thing to do is to test. So we go to step 5. This is where we try, we fail, we learn, and we repeat the process. So one usual UX activity involved here is usability testing. So this is like a user interview where you have a one-on-one with the user, but instead of like asking them questions, we invite a user to try out the design we made, the prototypes we made. So we give them tasks that they need to accomplish. And during that session, we encourage them to think out loud, like what they're feeling, what they're thinking, and what they're doing, so that we can refer back to like our journeys kung tama ba talaga, like ito ba talaga yung nangyari. So here, we will take note of what areas of the design or like the prototype we did yung pwede pa nating i-iterate or there are problems. So if in this usability test, good yung results, like there are no negative feedbacks, everything is positive, and the tasks were done very well, then you're ready for development na. You're gonna pass it on to the developers and you're finished with the design. And if bad results naman, don't worry because that's completely fine. You will work on the feedback na natanggap mo and just test it again. So you will iterate on your design and then later on, usability testing ulit. Okay, that is a lot. There is so much involved in UX, yes. But do you really need this all? Yes and no. Yes, why yes? Because going back, sinabi ko a while ago that you can't just simply take one part of the process and call it UX. So all of these processes will help you reach your goal, which is to give the best experience to your users. And why no naman? Because you don't have to go through all of these steps every time you do a project. Well, if you have the luxury, like, why not? Pero sheesh, do you have the time really to do all of these stuffs? Like, but keep in mind that great user experience, it also considers feasibility along with these stuff, desirability and viability. So do you have enough time, resources, money to do all of these things? So what's important here is just to remember to be intentional every step of the way. And like in the process of defining, in the process of ideating, you're doing it with the best that you can. Because who are you doing it for? It's for your users. And what is our goal? To make them happy, right? Okay. So you might be asking, why do I need user experience? Or why do we do user experience? So basically, in user experience, what we're trying to do is to lessen the friction between accomplishing a task and using the tool to reach their goals. So basically, we do research to know what to commit to and what to avoid. Then we do testings to evaluate if our design really solves the problem or meron pa rin mga loopholes that needs fixing. So with this testing and with these interviews, we use UX to create a product that would bridge the user from point A to point B. So if it still doesn't make sense or like it doesn't convince you pa, okay, take two. Here's another reason why. We do UX because we want to de-risk the solution to the problem being solved, or like your solution to the problem. So for sure, you don't want to spend hours and days you're designing on Figma only to find out that wala namang gagamit ng design mo because all of the problem solving happened inside your head lang. You didn't reach out to users. Sobrang hypothetical na mga problems. So we de-risk our products by involving the people who will be using them. So as UX designers, we are the voice of the users, but it is clear that we are not the users. Like they have their own problems, we have our own problems, and we're trying to solve theirs, not ours. So sometimes we have to be honest with ourselves that we don't know everything, and that's why we do UX. So, okay, medyo nagsisink in na. Okay, UX, but how do I fit in? So this is a question I had personally then before when I came to UX. Because from high school before, like my background ko was business. And then right now I'm taking a fine arts major in Ateneo. So I don't really have a legit tech background. So how do I fit in UX? You can. So for graphic designers, you already know how to design layers of information. So you have the skills to make things look pretty. You can evoke the desired emotions in your design. So I say this is an advantage because there is a thing in UX called aesthetic usability effect. So it basically means that people will consider pretty designs to be easier to use than subpar or ugly ones because pretty designs usually covers usability flaws. So if you want to learn more why aesthetics is valuable in UX, check this bit.ly/aesthetics in UX link. I rambled about aesthetics there. And then for developers naman, you already see the edge cases of the design. So you thinker through what is possible to be coded and what is impossible. So having this skill is very essential because it saves you and your team a lot of time. So you already know how to code the designs you make and you'll not design something that is impossible or like that may introduce problems in the long run. Plus you can code your design. Like that's one step closer to becoming a unicorn designer. So yes, anyone can be a UX designer. Ayun. So here, going back to what UX design means, it's the process of improving the end user's experience. So UX design is all about improving the outcome and not the output. So what are these outcomes? So these outcomes can be like a kid learning how to order her favorite ice cream flavor online, posting something in the marketplace, or checking out all your items from your 11-11 boodle cart. So kayo guys, meron ba kayo mga boodles there? Ano yung mga binili nyo 2 days ago? Kasi ako, like, wala ako nabili. Because hindi ako nagpa-fall into temptation. I'm saving for a thing that I really like. Probably at the end of the year. Chat nyo naman. Like, I wanna see. Ano yung mga binili nyo? Ayun, your gaming mouse. For Genshin ba to? Anyways, so basically, these are good outcomes. And each one makes the user happy. So though it seems a lot to become a UX designer, with the activities that I ran you guys through a while ago, it just really takes small steps to get better in UX. yes, you will be going through research, you will be going through feedbacks, journey maps, and also the interfaces and websites. But soon, these processes will be second nature for you. Like, it's gonna be easy. So what you have to remember lang is to always start with the end in mind. And what is that end? What is that goal? Your goal in UX is how might we put a smile on the user's face? So that's it for me, guys. I hope you enjoyed the crash course. Drop your questions in the Notion forms link below and we will answer them for you. Hope you learned a lot. Bye.
All right. Wow. Thank you so much for that, Rafa. Truly anyone can be a UX designer. So I hope that wasn't too much to take in for all of you, but just in case, we'll be having a 5-minute break before we proceed with the next batch. So please be back by 2:45.
I'm walking fast.